So, hi, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, jadi buat korang yang masih belum mengenali saya, nama saya Nur Auni Shakira binti Zamrai, yang lebih dikenali dengan Auni ataupun Oni, you can call me anything. Okay, so saya ni sebenarnya orang Terengganu. Jadi sometimes when I try to approach someone or anything or just like talking with someone, I prefer to talk in English actually, but I try my best to cakap bahasa Melayu bangku so that kalau tiba-tiba keluar bahasa Terengganu tu korang faham lah ya. Okay, jadi untuk video kali ni, purposely saya sebenarnya nak menjawablah soalan-soalan korang ni. Soalan banyak lah korang tanya pasal how to survive, how is your journey, macam tu lah soalan-soalan dia, contoh dia. Okay, so let me go to the first question, which is the most frequent question that I receive, which is what is your journey? Okay, jadi bercakap berkenaan dengan journey ni, it's a very long story if I tell you from tadika and then primary and then. Okay, so but I just tell you roughly where did I study, okay, like that. Okay, so it's kind of privacy, but for you guys, I just tell you, but not too details lah. Alright, okay, so dulu sekolah masa tadika dulu, saya ada sekolah tadika lah. Saya dulu tadika di Umu Akilah, which is the best kindergarten. Okay, and then Pasti also, which is near my house. Okay, so once I was 7 years old, I went to SK Padang Leran, which was my father's school. I mean like my father worked there lah. So means masa tu, kira anak cikgu lah dekat sekolah rendah dulu kan. And then, Alhamdulillah, for UPSR, I got 5 A's. So, with that result, I received the offer to study in Lembah Bidung, which is one of the SPP. But then, it's quite far away from me. So, I really not prepare myself to be in hostel sometimes. I mean, like, I want to be at home. So, then, I just go to SMK Sheikh Abdul Malik, which is near my house, which is beside my house without any traffic light, any jam. So, yeah. Okay, so even though the school is just near with my house, so it doesn't mean that the school is just a normal school. So it's a very good school. I mean like, I have a lot of advantage to be in that school. Okay, so first of all, of course, the school is just near with my house, just 5 minutes away from my house. So I just go to the school 5 minutes before the limit times of lewat lah. Kiranya kalau lewat 7.20, 7 suku baru tolak. So janganlah contohi. Dulu dah lah pengawas tapi perangai macam ni. It should be like that. Second one is because even though it's not like a high level school, but it's still the best school for a competitive environment lah. Because my batch masa tu, dia punya intake student is only for 5A student. So all my batch is from the 5A UPSR student. So we want that competitive environment so that we can study and fight to each other dengan sehat. Alhamdulillah. It's good to be there. And the third one is I love to be in that school. It's because of the environment itself. So, FYI, that school is actually a religious school. So, I mean like dia punya environment tu terjaga lah. And then we already taught how to be a very good student duniawi and ukhrawi. So, the principle is we don't want to be successful in dunia only, but also in akhirah. Because the akhirah hereafter is a long journey after our dunia. So, we want to teach ourselves, want to make sure that we go aligned with the path, and also we never neglect our religion, our belief, our thoughts, our faith to Allah, to be parallel to each other so we can successful dunia and akhirah. So that just only my point of view, my advice to you guys also. Macam ceramah pula kan. If you want to be successful, never ever neglect our hereafter day. Remember. Okay. And then, PT3, Alhamdulillah, I got 11 A's. Straight A's in PT3. And after the result came out, my parents want me to study further. I mean like, my mums and my dad want me go far actually. But myself, I don't want her. I want to be here. I already have my friend here. I already have my study group here in SMK Sheikh Abdul Malik. So why need I go to the other school? Why need I need to adapt in my new environment? Why need I need to do a new friends? I think it's just like a mess up for me. I just only have 2 years more to SPM. Why need I need to do reboot again? So I mean like masa leceh lah kan. nak kena buat semua benda balik. So macam tak nak, aku sayang kawan-kawan aku, aku sayang study group aku, aku sayang kompetitif aku kat dalam sekolah tu. So dia macam punya fikiran tu sampai tahap macam tu lah. Tapi but then I still lah ikut cakap mak ayah kan. Cakap mak ayah, okay tak apalah, kita try lah apply. So at the time I try apply KISAS and surprisingly I got the offer. So at that time I really really feel like, oh nak pergi ke tak, nak pergi ke tak. Of course lah, my parents want me to go there, but sometimes I use the reasons that I told you just now, that I don't want to go to the other school, adapt to the new environment, to be create new friends. I don't want to mess up in my 2 years for SPM to do that again. Yeah? So my parents just okay, ikut pandai lah nak buat apa-apa pun. So yeah, I stay in my secondary school for 2 years more until SPM. Okay, so in SPM, actually, I didn't get straight A's. Unfortunately, I really, really sad. I really, really disappointed myself. Sometimes I target a lot of A plus, but surprisingly, I got one B plus, which is unexpectedly the subject that I always receive A plus, but then in SPM I got B plus. And that is the dangerous when you are in the comfort zone. So this is my advice to you guys for the SPM candidates out there yang sekarang ni SPM, calon SPM akan datang. So please, kalau korang straight A's from the beginning or dapat A plus ke subject tu or dapat A, jangan pernah rasa like, okay aku dah boleh buat ni. So that's the result. Ta-da. If you want to know my SPM result, actually I got 6 A plus, 3 A, 1 A minus and 1 B plus. So total 10 A's and 1 B lah. So yeah, that's the real story of myself. So lupa nak cakap, for those yang nak sambung medic, you need to sambung aliran sains lah. Either aliran sains agama ke, aliran sains tulen ke. Yang pasti kena ada biology, physics and chemistry. Okay, so three things ni is a very important and crucial thing lah kalau you nak apply medic. That is the fact, okay. Jadi itulah kisah sampai kat SPM lah. Okay, jadi lepas SPM tu, I need apply lah. Apply for UPU, of course lah, as usual kan. I also apply for IPG, surprisingly. Sebab tu mak ayah yang suruh, mak ayah kan cikgu. So macam mak ayah pun nak lah anak dia ni macam ikut jejak ke, I'm not sure that kind of things. But to be honest, I really really want to be a doctor since I was 6 years old actually. And I really really into biology, in science in my secondary school. So I think that's no compromise or no reason I want to exclude medicine course just to pursue teachers or whatsoever. Jadi waktu lepas minta IPG tu, I go lah to interview itself. So waktu interview ni, my parents told me lah, kalau tak nak cikgu sekalipun, bagi tahu je nak cikgu. I mean like, okay, ni macam like kena paksa ni, okay. But then I try lah, like okay, waktu interview tu bila dia tanya, okay memang nak cikgu ke, okay I'm just like, okay I want. So yeah, macam tu lah. But surprisingly, I got the offer to be in IPG in Penang in subject science. So I mean like, oh my god, I'm confused in the second time, I need to choose what.